Diva log. A very happy Choti Diwali to all of you guys. We just finished up with the puja and just sitting and chilling with family, and that's why the situation is going on. But yes, a very very happy Choti Diwali to you guys. Last year on Choti Diwali, I shared my quintessential Diwali haul with you all. This haul particularly is about the things that you would actually be buying for Diwali and not for yourself because it's Diwali. There's a difference there, guys. So I will be sharing with you everything that I've bought this year so you can see what I've actually bought for Diwali. And yes, without any further ado, let's get into the video. I wanted to actually ask you guys to leave a comment in the comment section down below letting me know what are your quintessential Diwali items. It can be anything. There's so many different cultures in India and even abroad for people who celebrate Diwali abroad, like Indonesia or maybe Sri Lanka. Like, there's so many different cultures, and of course every culture asks for different things. So I would love to know what you guys have, like quintessential items that you guys have to celebrate Diwali. And now, without any further blabbering, let's get into the video. First things first, I got these Lakshmi ji and Ganesh ji. They are so cute. They're not super huge, they're very tiny. They're silver, they're made out of silver, that's what I meant. And I felt they look really cute. I got them actually not right now, but a while back when I was in Kota, Rajasthan. So I got them from there and they just look so nice. And Lakshmi ji and Ganesh ji are very integral to Diwali. You keep them and you do puja around them. Although Ram ji came back, but we kind of worship Lakshmi ji and Ganesh ji. So this is a very quintessential thing to have for most North Indian homes. So yeah, this year we got new Lakshmi ji and Ganesh ji. I had one previously, of course, but we just thought it would be really nice to get new ones. So yeah, that's the first thing that I bought for Diwali this year. Then of course, we have loads of diyas. So one main diya, one big diya that will be kind of lit all night because it's lit. Diwali is lit, you guys. That's a pun you should be using on your Diwali captions. Thank me later. But yes, the big diya, and then obviously there are a lot of smaller diyas. I have, I think, about 31 small diyas. We light up 21 in the main puja, and then the others we just keep around the house. Post the diyas, I have some rangoli colors. I've had some from previous year, but these are some that I did not have, so I need to stock up on them. So I got a white, I got a blue, I got a green, a red, and a yellow. And I love making rangoli. I just feel so happy whenever I make a rangoli. It's just one of those stress busters for me almost. So the post lunch time after hogging on all of the puris and everything is my time when I make the rangoli, and I take my complete time with it. I enjoy doing it. So yes, I will be making the rangoli tomorrow, and I'm not too sure what I want to make right now, but I'll just look up some nice designs or maybe just, you know, create something with my own hands. Then I have Keel and Batashe, and I really really wish they weren't in plastic, but that's how the vendor gave it to us. And I asked him if he had any other packet, but he did not. So yeah, so Keel basically is puffed rice, and batashe are made out of sugar, and these are super integral to the puja that we do. And we kind of offer this to the diyas, and this we give out as prasad. So these two things are very 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 important. Like, without this, no Diwali is complete. And we literally wait for the prasad. Along with this, we also have shakkarpare and so many other things, but we all wait for this. Then I bought a lot of flower garlands, like a lot of flower garlands to just decorate my house and everything. And these are not real flowers, you guys. These are more like tissue paper flowers, and they look really pretty. So these are up in my living area and then on my gates and everything, and they look so pretty and so vibrant. They just add such a nice festive touch. I only have two here with me because I didn't want to take all of them down as they're already up. But yes, I just wanted to show you that I bought these, and they are so cute. This one I got from Sadar Bazaar, Delhi, and the colors and Keel Batashe are just from Karol Bagh market, and I'm pretty sure you can get them anywhere right now. And honestly, if you get them right now, like tomorrow on the day of Diwali, it's even more exciting. I remember when I used to celebrate Diwali in Alwar, me and my cousins, we all used to go out on the day of Diwali to get khilone. Khilone are made out of sugar, like those different figures that are made out of sugar. I don't know if like they have it in Delhi as well, but Alwar had them and we were crazy about them. So we used to go out on Diwali, like after our lunch, and we used to get all of these crazy little things for decorations and everything, and for eating, of course. But yeah, that was so exciting. I missed that part of my childhood, honestly. But that's not what this video is about. So yeah, flower garlands were next up. Next up, I have khadiya and geru, and if you have no idea what these are, so these are sort of paints but in pieces of chalk, so you kind of soak them overnight. Khadiya is white, and geru, if the name doesn't already give it away, is, wait for the big reveal, a red. So these I think are more integral to Rajasthani culture than any other culture. So before I used to use colorful rangoli because that's more mainstream. I used to make rangoli with these. I still do. So we make different patterns and everything. I think even Bengalis do alpona, and that's sort of similar to it, like on the parallel lines. I'm not sure if it's the same thing or not. But yeah, we use khadiya and gher when we create different patterns, and then we create different things on different places of house to ensure that Lakshmiji visits that place as well. So for example, in the kitchen you would draw chakla, bel and sandasi and all of that, and under the diyas you would, like under the place where you would keep diyas, you would actually draw diyas. It's just a part of my life that I'm really happy to have, because I love these little things. So yeah, got khadiya and gheru finally in Delhi, because there were 2 years that I couldn't find khadiya and gheru in Delhi, and finally I got them. So I'm so happy, so happy. Then I have battis. Battis are just sort of like twisted cotton jyot batti. So these go into the diya. This is what lights up when you light up the diya. You can obviously make this at home with cotton, but you get packs of these which are very affordable. So why not? This is gonna save some of your time if you lead a very busy lifestyle like me, doing nothing, sitting on the bed all day long. But yeah, so I got these. These are actually also a great way to ensure that someone else can earn something for Diwali as well. That's what I feel. Like there's so many things that you can do at home yourself, but if you have the ability to help someone out on Diwali, then why not? So yeah, got these. And some are missing because we obviously use them for today's puja, and the others are for tomorrow's puja. The last thing I have is moli, which is a sacred thread, and you tie it around your hand. I already have some on my hand from different places and jagratas and whatnot. But yes, you tie this around your hand for protection and everything. We also tie it around a diya, and you can tie it around trees. There's just so many places that this thread is used, and it's just a very nice part of the puja. I really like it. But yeah, it's a very integral part of North Indian pujas. That's what I know. I'm not sure about other areas. I would really love if you guys could fill me in with the info. But yeah, super important for puja. And of course, there are things from here and there that I've bought throughout the year for Diwali, like some home decor items or some candles or anything. And they're all around my house right now. They're all up in their places already. So I can't show them to you guys because they're already like set up and everything. But yes, that was majorly my quintessential Diwali haul for this year. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a lovely Choti Diwali, or had a lovely Choti Diwali. And yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow for the last Diwalog for this year. And till then, take care. I love you all so much. Bye.